Welcome to the first lesson in the thrv Jobs to be Done Innovation course. I'm Jay Haynes, the founder and CEO of thrv. Imagine you are on a product, marketing, or sales team, and your mission is to beat Apple and Google Maps. How would you do it? We will show you how to use an innovation method called Jobs to be Done, also known as JTBD, or Jobs Theory. The core idea behind Jobs Theory is deceptively simple. Jobs Theory shows that your customers are not actually buying your product. They are hiring your product to get a job done. We will explain this in detail throughout this course. This is an extremely powerful insight because your customers' struggle to get their job done is what causes them to make a new purchase. Jobs Theory centers your product, marketing, and sales teams on your customers' struggle. This is why it works. This method helps you and your team gain agreement faster on the best product ideas for your roadmap and the best marketing messages. Jobs Theory helps your company sell more of your product faster. Let's look at how to beat Apple and Google Maps using Jobs Theory. In the 1960s, Professor Theodore Levitt was famous for saying customers don't want a quarter-inch drill, they want a quarter-inch hole. This idea is the core of Jobs Theory, and it is true in any market, including yours. For example, consumers don't want navigation apps like Apple or Google Maps, which are products. They want to get to a destination on time, which is a job to be done. The products to get this job done have changed dramatically over time, but the job is the same. If you are going to beat Apple and Google Maps, you start by analyzing the customer's job of getting to a destination on time. Your customer's job is your market, so it is critical to redefine your market using your customer's job rather than your product. This is a key insight from Jobs Theory, that while products change over time, your customer's job to be done is stable. History is full of examples of once dominant companies that failed because they defined their markets using their product. For example, BlackBerry thought there was a market for keyboard devices, and they lost $50 billion in equity value. Britannica thought there was a market for encyclopedias, and they lost almost 100% of their sales in just 6 years. Kodak thought there was a market for film and went from a $30 billion market value to bankruptcy. There are no keyboard device, encyclopedia, or film markets. These are all products that changed over time. But there have been and always will be markets to execute jobs while mobile, to find information, and to share memories. These are all stable jobs that will not change over time. Apple, Google, and Facebook became three of the most valuable companies in history in the exact same markets as BlackBerry, Britannica, and Kodak. Throughout this course, we will explain Jobs Theory in detail using examples in consumer markets, examples in business markets, and examples in medical markets. To execute Jobs Theory, we will show you how to identify your customers' unmet needs, how to identify weaknesses in your competitors' products, and how to generate high-growth product ideas and marketing messages to sell more of your product faster. To identify unmet needs, the first question we need to answer is, what is a customer need? Almost all companies do not agree on what a customer need even is. This is a serious problem, and it is probably true at your company. Your customer's job is a goal they need to achieve, independent of your product or service. Customer needs are the variables required for your customer to achieve their goal. If getting the job done is slow and inaccurate, this is the problem you need to solve for your customer. In the 1940s, a mathematician named George Paglia developed a method to solve problems that entailed four main steps: understanding the problem, planning to solve it, executing the solution, and assessing how well the solution worked. We add a revision step and a conclusion step to categorize the six types of job steps a customer has to go through to solve their problem. In other words, to get their job done. For example, in getting to a destination on time, a consumer has to estimate the departure time, plan the stops, travel to the destination, assess when the destination will be reached, reset the route if needed, and park the vehicle. These are 12 of the steps a consumer has to execute to get to a destination on time. Like your customer's job, this job is complex. Job steps help you identify your customer's needs. A customer need is an action a customer must take using a variable to get a job step done. This concept that a need is an action plus a variable is an important concept to remember. For example, in getting to a destination on time, one of the job steps is to plan the stops. In order to plan the stops in a busy day, a consumer must know variables, including the optimal sequence of the stops, the routes to the stops, and open times at the stops. These are all variables in this job step, and a consumer has to take actions with each of these variables. For example, determine the optimal sequence to make planned stops. Now that we have actions and variables, we have well-defined and quantitative customer needs. As we saw before, products change over time, but customer jobs are stable. This is true for customer needs as well. They are stable and do not change over time. This is a huge advantage with jobs theory. You will have a stable set of customer needs for your product, marketing, and sales teams to target. All customer needs have a customer action and a variable, so you can measure the speed of the customer's action and the accuracy of the variable. You create customer value by getting your customer's job done faster and more accurately than your competitors. This is another important jobs theory concept to remember. Your goal as a team is to help your customer get their job done as fast and accurately as possible. To uncover customer needs, you can conduct customer interviews to define your customer, identify the job and job steps in your market, and uncover all the customer needs in each step. We will show you how to conduct these interviews in later lessons. In our example of getting to a destination on time, there are over 100 customer needs, which is typical of every job to be done. Now that we have well-defined customer needs, the next question is, what is an unmet need? We know a customer need is an action plus a variable. If the action is not quick and/or the variable is not accurate, the need is unmet by current competitive solutions in your market. This makes sense because we know that your customer's struggle to get their job done is what causes a new purchase of a product. In our example of getting to a destination on time, determining the optimal sequence of planned stops is a manual process that is slow and inaccurate. So this is an unmet need in this market. You can survey customers to identify and prioritize unmet needs in your customer's job and identify the most underserved and most valuable customer segment in your market. With a job survey, you can size your market opportunity and price your product more accurately. We will show you how to survey your customers in later lessons. The next step to execute jobs theory is critically important. You should identify your competitor's product weaknesses so you can exploit them. You can identify competitor weaknesses using unmet needs in your customer's job. For example, if a consumer were to determine the optimal sequence of planned stops using Apple or Google Maps, how would she do it? She would have to enter destination A to B, calculate the route and time, enter destination A to C, calculate the route and time, and replan if going from A to C first was faster. Then repeat this manual process for every possible combination of stops in her day. If she tried to do this with multiple stops in a busy day, it would be slow and inaccurate because she would have to know all the possible routes, traffic, construction, events, and weather along the routes. So her speed is slow and the accuracy is low if she could even successfully determine the optimal sequence at all. This is a weakness in Apple and Google Maps. A competitor weakness is slow and inaccurate satisfaction of a customer need. This is another important concept to remember. This is how you can use unmet needs in your customer's job to discover weaknesses in even the most successful competitors, including Apple and Google. Finally, let's generate high-growth product ideas and marketing messages. Your customers' unmet needs in their job are the criteria to judge your product feature ideas for your roadmap. So let's compare two product ideas to satisfy this unmet customer need. Our first idea is to create an assistant service. A customer would call a remote assistant who would have access to their calendar. The assistant would make recommendations to reorder their stops to keep them on time. We can estimate the speed and accuracy of our new feature idea. It would take a couple of minutes, and the assistant would be able to find more information about the routes and destination, so the service would likely be more accurate. Since customer needs are metrics, you should assess the speed and accuracy of all of the feature ideas in your roadmap. This is a critical jobs theory concept that will help you beat your competition and mitigate your risk of failure. Our second feature idea is called Sync and Optimize. This feature will sync to a user's calendar, like this one, and include an optimization algorithm. A user simply clicks the Optimize button, and the Sync and Optimize feature automatically optimizes the sequence of their planned stops. We can assess the speed and accuracy of our Sync and Optimize feature against Apple and Google Maps and against our first assistant service idea. It takes only a second to use, and we can test the optimization algorithm to ensure it is highly accurate. Jobs theory helps you and your team gain agreement on which feature ideas to build and prioritize. In our example, our Sync and Optimize idea will satisfy an unmet customer need faster and more accurately than Apple and Google Maps. This is customer value. Customer value is getting your customer's job done faster and more accurately than your competitors. Products that create more customer value win in every market. You can use unmet needs in your customer's job to create marketing messages that will resonate. In our example, we would call the new product On Time and message to optimizing a consumer's busy day to keep them on time, confident, and relaxed. This is how you use jobs theory to build a feature thesis for your product roadmap. It starts with defining your customer and their job to be done, and then identifying the job step and unmet need you will target. Your feature idea should clearly explain how it will satisfy unmet needs faster and more accurately than your competitors. And your marketing message should explain how your feature satisfies the unmet need to generate positive emotions for your customer. Products that get the job done sell more faster. Your goal is to build, market, and sell products that get the job done for your customer. This lesson has given a brief overview of jobs theory. We hope you will share and like this video on YouTube. In our next lesson, we will show you how to define your customers to avoid customer flaws that result in your competition stealing your customers and your market share. Visit us at thrv.com to get our free how-to guides and try our Jobs to Be Done software for free.